Hello friends, in this video I am going to show you the method of doing sequential fluoroscopic dilatation of urethral stricture in an adult male. This video comes to you from Dalela Academy of Urology. A 52 years old male developed a catheter induced urethral stricture after 6 weeks of catheter removal. His uroflow graph showed significant obstruction to bladder outlet. His stream was very thin and he needed to strain to void. He had been scheduled for sequential dilatation of his stricture over the guide wire. I also like to call this procedure as coaxial dilatation of stricture because the stricture is sequentially dilated over the axis of the guide wire. So it practically means the same thing, coaxial or sequential dilatation. The gadgets that you may need for this procedure are a set of Teflon coated semi-flexible urethral dilators which come in various sizes from 8 French to 18 French, and then you need a hydrogel coated guide wire, floppy tip guide wire, topical xylocaine liquid, I use sometimes 4%, and a tube of xylocaine gel 2%. The patient is positioned in the operation theater under the C-arm and in a position that one would use for doing a retrograde urethrogram, that is right oblique position, and the thigh is flexed. The meatus is first of all lubricated with gel, and then you instill about 8 to 10 ml of radiographic contrast to opacify the urethra and see the stricture in image intensifier and in fluoroscopy. As you can see here, the instilled contrast is filling up the urethra, distending the urethra, and then you can see contrast going in the bladder lumen. You can actually see the entire urethra. You must observe the distensibility of the urethra here. In a normal segment, urethra will distend, and in a diseased segment or in a strictured segment, it may not. So obtain an idea of the entire urethra here. Then pass a floppy tip guide wire, which is a hydrogel coated guide wire. It's 0.035 inch wire. Gently you insert this in the urethral lumen. Because urethra is well lubricated, it will find its way through the stricture, all the strictures, and then go into the urinary bladder. By the amount of the loss of resistance and the ease of passing the wire, you would know that you are in the correct passage. Introduce a little more wire in the bladder so that it does not slip out. The extra contrast is ejected out. And now you're ready for the dilatation. Lubricate the urethra with xylocaine gel again, some more. And over the guide wire, first you pass the first dilator, which is the 8 French urethral dilator. While you are dilating the stricture, with the left hand, pull the penis towards yourself so that you straighten the penis. And in a straight penis, you advance the dilator over the guide wire. Initial dilators usually go easily. You must remember to be very gentle and be very slow, and you can watch the entry of dilator in the bladder on fluoroscopy. Having done that, you can withdraw the dilator, and every time the dilator comes out, please look for any blood at the dilator or the blood coming out of the meatus. Next, you pass another dilator 10 French in size over the guide wire following the same technique. Watch the entry in the urinary bladder. As I said, be very gentle by dilating the stricture. Don't use any force. Withdraw the dilator again gently, and then watch for any blood at the meatus or at the dilator tip. Then you pass third dilator. So you will appreciate that we are increasing the caliber of the dilator. So from 8 French to 10 French to 12 French, that's why the name sequential dilatation. And when you insert the dilator in the bladder, remember, don't over-insert it in the bladder. Having dilated the stricture, withdraw this dilator, and now is the time to pass next dilator, which is of increasing caliber. Again, follow it up over the guide wire. Now, as you insert this dilator in the bladder, remember, don't over-insert it, because the tip can hurt the bladder wall. So at that stage, you need fluoroscopic vision. So this dilator is also removed. Now you are passing thicker and thicker dilator. This time it is a 16 French dilator over the guide wire. Now, as you pass these thicker dilators in the prostatic urethra, you have to bend, you know, the dilator towards the OT table. That means you have to ventriflex the penis in between the thighs, so as to tilt the dilator so that it gets negotiated easily through the bladder neck into the bladder. Withdraw this dilator and now pass the 18 French dilator. And you may not pass 18 French dilator in everybody. 16 French is reasonable, but here in this case we decided to do up to 18 French. So that's what we are using. Now remember, as you pass thicker dilators at this point of sphincter urethra, prostatic urethra and bladder neck, you have to bend the dilator and you have to be very careful so that you don't injure the bladder neck here, right, by the tip of the dilator, and just maintain the steady pressure. The dilator will find its way in the bladder on its own. Give some angulation, and that's what you need. Having dilated the stricture, you should retain the dilator within the urethra for about, I would say, something about half a minute. This is to maintain a centrifugal stretch on the stricture. And having done that, you withdraw the dilator out of the penis. And then you must watch for any blood coming out of the external urinary meatus. The absence of blood at the meatus is the sign of your gentleness. So that is what you must always aim for. If you want, at this stage, you can thread the catheter over the wire. But most patients don't need a catheter if they don't bleed. Why do I recommend the use of fluoroscopic guidance at the time of the dilatation is, first of all, it allows accurate placement of guide wire. And if the guide wire is accurately placed through the stricture, through the prostatic urethra into the bladder, then your dilatation is safe. You will never create a false passage. So that's one clear advantage. The second advantage that I see is that it allows for, you know, angulation of dilator while you are passing the thicker dilators through the bladder neck. As you saw in the video, when you use 16 French or 18 French dilator, they can cause some injury at the bladder neck. So you should know where your dilator is going, and that will happen only when you use fluoroscopy. So that's the second advantage of using fluoroscopy here. And the third advantage that I realize is that once you pass the dilator, you would know how much of dilator has gone inside the bladder. And you do not over-insert the dilator and you do not cause injury to the bladder wall by the tip of your dilator. So these are three distinct advantages which you have if you use a fluoroscopy while you are dilating. Some people with experience can place guide wire even without fluoroscopy. They can do dilatation even without fluoroscopy. But I must say that that is possible, but then you should be extra careful. And if you have any difficulty, you should abandon the procedure and ask for fluoroscopic help. So thank you very much for watching this video, and you can email your comments and questions to me. Thank you again.